everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Well, yes guys, you know it already all, you've seen the thumbnail. Today we're going to make a Lady Gaga doll. I don't even know what to say. I adore Lady Gaga, I bet you adore Lady Gaga, everyone adores Lady Gaga, and everyone has been asking me to make a Lady Gaga doll since the beginning of my channel. But of course, it's such a huge responsibility. I don't know, I just didn't dare to start working on the Gaga doll for years, but now I think it's time. I feel strong enough to make a good quality Lady Gaga doll. And also right now in a couple of days, for you when you're watching this video, for me it's still in a couple of weeks, Gaga is going to release her new album. So I think it's a very good time to make finally a Lady Gaga doll. I'm going to keep this intro very short because I have extremely a lot of work this week on this doll, so I'm going to start working, and you please, of course, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, don't forget to hit the like button, don't forget to hit the bell button, and I'm going to start my transformation. I was planning this makeover for years, but I could never find a doll that would have at least a little bit similar face. And now I think I've got one. Look, I think this Barbie doll is just ideal for my mini Gaga. But wait, I will open the box probably, because you can see approximately nothing because of the reflection. So, this Barbie fashionista, she already looks kinda like Lady Gaga. The face mold is really perfect, even the hair color is okay, but I'm going to reroot her hair anyway because I don't like the quality of this hair, and I also think that her hair is supposed to be a bit longer. So this is where I'm going to start, but let's first of all remove this outfit and cut her original hair off. I use, like always, hot air of my hair dryer to make the doll's head soft, and after doing this for a couple of minutes, I can easily disconnect it from the body without cracking the neck, because it's always quite a risky business, you know. Then I take my tweezers and I remove the rest of the hair from the inside of the head. And then it's time for me to take pure acetone and to remove this doll's original makeup. So, since I'm going to recreate today the Lady Gaga's look from the new album that was supposed to come out on the 10th of April but was postponed like everything is on this planet right now, so that's why I'm going to give her this pink hair, and I think it's quite close to the original. But first I'm going to paint her head with a couple of layers of pink acrylics matching this hair color. And then I'm taking my rerouting tool and I'm refilling all these holes in her head with this new hair. So, this is how it looks about 4 hours later. I've already separated the front part, we will need it later when I will style her hair. And now I can take tacky glue and fix all this new hair inside of the head. When the glue gets dry, I spray the face with a couple of layers of Mr. Super Clear sealant. It makes the rubber surface more paper-like, and like this I can draw easily on her face with my watercolor pencils. So when I start with sketching her eyes, eyebrows, and applying shadows with soft pastels. Gaga has a very bright pink eye makeup on the reference pictures, so I will have to layer pastels to reach a very nice coverage. And then I'm going through my regular face drawing routine, applying shadows and highlights, and then again more shadows, and after this some more highlights. You know, if you watch my videos regularly, you know all the steps already out of your head probably. So now the face has been finished and I think we can move on, and first of all I'm going to give her this fully articulated body from another Barbie made to move doll, because with this body our mini Gaga will be able to dance and to pose like a real superstar. So now let's give this body a quick makeover as well. I'm going to start with sanding this body with nail buffers to remove the gloss from the top of the surface, because like this paint and pastels, they will go better on later. Then I spray the body with a couple of layers of Mr. Super Clear sealant, and after this we will cover the body with the same pastels like we've just used for her face. The next step is quite difficult, guys, because we're going to try to recreate Gaga's tattoos, and she has quite a lot of them, so I've collected lots of reference pictures and now I'm going to copy them one by one on this doll's body. So let's start probably with the easiest one, with a peace sign inspired by John Lennon on her left wrist. On the inside of her left upper arm, she has a quote in German from Rainer Maria Rilke's Letters to a Young Poet. And this is quite a big tattoo with a lot of text written in German. So I don't know, I will probably not copy it letter per letter because it will be anyway unreadable in this scale, let's be honest. And it will also be difficult to fit the complete text. So I will kind of just imitate it to make it look like the original tattoo. So then we have a tattoo Joanne on her arm written in her aunt Joanne's handwriting. The trumpet tattoo was made in honor of the jazz singer who actually drew the image specifically for Gaga. In 2012, after announcing that she was releasing an album titled Art Pop, she tattooed this word on her left wrist. So let's draw it as well. Then we have a very cute mouse tattoo. It's dedicated to her younger sister, whose home name was Mouse. And then Gaga added a house tattoo just above the mouse on the back of her arm in honor of House Gaga's 10th anniversary in 2016. And then we have a musical note tattoo on her right forearm. The same month when Gaga announced her new album Born This Way, she tattooed a unicorn wrapped in a banner reading the same three words, Born This Way, on the top of her leg. So, and now let's move on from the single tattoos to the big group of them on the back and on the side of the ribs. And I'm going to sketch them first with a brown pencil to be sure that there is space enough on her back. And I'm starting with the rose tattoo that goes down below the spine. Then we have a portrait of David Bowie on the side of the rib cage. On the lower back, she has roses created by Kat Von D, but in our case, the biggest part of this tattoo is going to be hidden under this sculpted underwear. So I will draw just the visible part of it. And there is also an anchor above it. Close to her neck, Gaga has a Tokyo Love tattoo. Under the Tokyo Love tattoo, there will be three daisies. On her shoulder, Gaga has a tattoo "Dead" written on the inside of a heart that she has made after her father underwent open heart surgery. Not far from the "Dead" tattoo, she has a Fire Rose Unity symbol. She also has a Mother Monster tattoo on her rib cage close to the armpit in honor of the 5-year anniversary of her album The Fame Monster, and it looks like I will have to make the anchor a bit smaller to fit the Mother Monster tattoo. You see, it's good I didn't draw it in black immediately because right now I can correct it still. And then I still need to draw this monster hand tattoo. Okay, and now I can take a black pencil and I will draw a final clean version of all these tattoos. So, this is what I've got. I don't know, maybe I've missed a couple of them, but after all, just Gaga knows all her tattoos. And anyway, it looks pretty cool, I think, on this doll. And really, you cannot imagine, guys, how scared I was even to start working on these tattoos. But they ended up very cool looking, so I can start working on her outfit. Here I have already prepared the doll body, protected it with masking tape, and I've also sketched the future outfit. And now we are going to try to recreate this costume out of Warbler thermoplastic. And I'm going to start with her bra and with her shorts probably, because they're the easiest to make. Her shorts, or how to call them, I don't know, panties, bikini bottom, it's made like some sort of a grid of chastity. It's like a hard construction that can go open and it has two locks on the sides. That's why I'm going to glue this tiny hinge strap to the parts of the outfit, and then I will be able to open and close it. And then I'm going to make the construction on her legs. After this, I want to make the most difficult part of the outfit, the shoulder construction. So in the beginning, I'm going to add some extra volume to the shoulders of the doll's body, and like this, it will be easier for me to sculpt the outfit. And then I'm making some sort of a carrying construction out of Warbler. And when the carrying construction has been finished, I take a foam paper, cut it into squares and circles, and I attach these tiny squares and circles to this Warbler on her shoulders using a glue gun. And this is what I've got after a couple of hours of working. It looks pretty good, I think. And now I can make the next part of the outfit, these monster gloves. I don't know how to call them, these monster hands. And I'm going to make them out of Warbler as well. So here is the finished outfit, and I'm going to complete it with this pair of Barbie shoes. But first of all, we're going to customize them, of course, because Gaga's shoes have really huge, massive platforms and also very high heels. So I start with cutting off the soles of the original shoes. Then I take sticky Warbler thermoplastic, I warm it up and I fold it a couple of times to make like a thick brick of Warbler, and then I glue my shoes to this sticky Warbler brick. After this, I can take a knife and I give these new soles and heels a nice shape. Okay, now the shoes are finished and I can cover everything first with white primer and then with a couple of layers of bright pink acrylics. And then I still want to add some extra shadows and highlights to make it all more three-dimensional. There are some kind of locks on her legs. It's very difficult to see it on this picture, but it seems like there are really like silver locks on each horizontal stripe. So let's imitate it using silver paper and a couple of silver beads. Gaga also has a couple of screws visible on her outfit, so I'm going to imitate them with the same silver balls. And her shoes are covered with the same beads as well, but in pink color. I don't know the correct name of these beads, I just know that this is normally a nail decoration. It's normally used in nail art. And then I cover the complete outfit with glossy acrylic varnish. So, the huge 5 days work on her outfit has been finished and I can go back to the doll's hair and face. And first of all, I'm going to style her hair to make it look like on the original pictures. And after this, I still need to attach the false lashes and to add glossy varnish to her eyes and lips. Okay, then she has this pink red metallic decoration on her face. I was really seriously doubting about it because it can be just too much for a tiny doll face. But anyway, let's try to attach it because I want to make like a complete copy of the original Gaga's outfit. And it looks pretty good, I think, yeah. I think I can keep it like this. So, after this I will finally put everything together and then we'll take a look at the end result pictures. So guys, here is my mini Gaga doll. It took me quite a long time to finish it, I can tell you honestly, because just making this outfit took a century. But right now, I'm very proud of the end result of my work this week, or this 3 weeks. Because yeah, it took almost 3 weeks for me to finish this doll. Really, I'm so happy that all these long hours of cutting and attaching tiny squares to the shoulders were not just gone for nothing. So now we just need to wait for a new album to come out and then we can compare my doll to the original Gaga look, because right now we have almost no pictures of it. So guys, what do you think about this transformation? And there's also another question, who else should we make next to continue my Sinner Diva collection? Please leave your impressions and suggestions in the comments under this video. And also guys, please share this video just, I don't know, anywhere on your social media if you want, and tag Gaga there, because who knows, maybe she would see it. Really, it would be just amazing if Lady Gaga could see my mini Gaga doll. Really. But without your help, it would not be possible, guys. And then I have a good news for you guys. Belgian Post started to accept international shipments again. And it means that this doll, together with other dolls that I've made during the lockdown, they're going to be for sale on eBay for 3 days, like always. You can see all these dolls on the screen now. So if you wanted to adopt one of them, the link will be in the description box under this video. So, and that was my doll transformation of the week, guys. I really hope you've enjoyed it today. And if so, please don't forget to support my art here on YouTube with your likes. Of course, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button. And I'm going to see you very soon, normally next week, Friday, in my new doll repaint video. Love you, guys. Bye.